code is one of the props, so I have to turn my code over. So this is Squanto.
Tis Squanto.
Yes, Mother?
Don't go near the white men.
I just want to get a closer look at their boats, Mother. Their boats are so big and can go fast and far on the water, much faster than our canoes.
But that's what scares me. If they get you on one of their boats, they can take you far away from here. Stay away from their boats.
Hey, boy, come here. Don't you want to take a closer look at our ships? Come on, lad. Let's go have a look-see. You'll be seeing it all the way back to England.
Squanto. In spite of the circumstances, though, he was gaining some positive things. The man in whose home he was staying, Sir Ferdinando Gorges, did not want to use Tisquantum for slave labor. He wanted to colonize America and use Tisquantum as a guide. So he gave him tutors to teach him English, and the English children even gave him a nickname.
Now, students, repeat after me one at a time. The rain in Spain stays mainly in the plain. Tisquantum, let's start with you.
The rain in Spain stays mainly in the plain.
Squanto, Squanto.
Yay, Squanto.
But now on, we'll call you Squanto.
Come here, Squanton.
Yes, sir.
You have been with me for 10 years now. You've been with me for 10 years now. You now know English. Would you like to come home to England? To the New World?
Yes, I'd be happy to, sir, to see my people.
mother. They have taught me their ways. They want to trade with our people.
Stay away from them. You have finally come home, and I do not want to lose you again.
Oh, don't worry, mother. They are my friends. They call me Squanto.
I like that name, Squanto. I will call you that.
I hope you will call me husband, and I will call you wife.
Once again, Squanto found himself facing terrible circumstances aboard an English ship. But this time, the ship sailed to the port of Malaga, Spain, where Squanto was sold as a slave. Little did he know, the man who bought him was a friar who was actually purchasing freedom for slaves. He offered them lodging in a monastery.
That wicked captain took us from our homes and families. Why are you so kind?
We try to be like our Lord and Master, Jesus. He is the Son of God.
I want to be like this Jesus that makes you so kind.
He died for all of our sins. Because he loves us, we can have everlasting life and go to heaven when we die.
Tell me more about this Jesus and his heaven. I want to know more. I believe that Jesus Christ is Lord.
Yes, Jesus is Lord.
Yes, Jesus is Lord.
Praise be to the one true God. Now we are all brothers in Christ.
Squanto became a Christian through the teachings of the kind friars in Spain. After a while, he made his way to England. Here, Squanto was hired as the scout and guide for a new world expedition headed by Captain Thomas Dermer, a good and compassionate man. 4 years had passed since he had been kidnapped. After reaching America, Squanto was eager to return to his village, his family, and his friends.
Well, we're here.
Over there, but it looks deserted.
Where are my people?
There's an Indian along the beach. Maybe he can tell us.
Ho, Squanto, welcome back, my brother. I have bad news for your ears.
What word do you bring, Samoset?
2 years ago, a white man's disease came to many of our villages. Braves, squaws, little children died. All in your tribe are dead. I'm sorry, my brother.
None escaped? Not my wife, my daughter, my mother? They're all dead? Oh, dear God, help me! All in my family are dead. I have no tribe, no people. How shall I keep on living? What purpose is there in my life? Oh, dear God, help me.
It is a blustery March day, 1621. 2 years have passed. The pilgrims who landed 4 months ago in the dead of winter have already lost nearly half their number to disease. 44 new graves have been dug in the cold New England ground. Despite their hardships, the pilgrims have begun to construct buildings and establish a colony. The new town of Plymouth is built on the very site of Squanto's deserted village of Pawtuxet.
Mr. Bradford, how will we ever survive? Mr. Standish says perhaps we should return to England when the Mayflower sails next month.
Yes, perhaps.
The Lord will help us. God has not led us to the New World just to abandon our heritage. We must trust in God.
Indians! Attack the woman and children.
Have no fear. I, Samoset, I bring my friend Squanto. He lives in this place many moons. He speaks white man's tongue.
Hello, I am Squanto. Welcome to Pawtuxet, the village of my father and his father before him.
Do you come in peace?
Yes, in peace. Twice I was captured and taken to England. There, I learned English.
We are sorry for your misfortunes. We wish you no harm. Why have you come to us?
I have served as a scout and guide on several trips to the New World. While I was away, all my tribe died of disease. I alone am left. I wondered why I was spared, but now I know. I have come to help you, and you shall be my people, and you shall be my tribe.
Surely God's providence is great.
Squanto proved to be a tremendous aid to the struggling Plymouth colony. His knowledge of hunting and fishing was invaluable. His skill at planting maize or Indian corn enabled the pilgrims to grow enough food to last them through the next terrible winter.
Mr. Squanto, why did we go fishing before we came to plant the corn? What are these fish for?
The corn is hungry. The ground is very tired, for my tribe has used this land for generations. If you do not put in the fish, the corn grows very small. Here, place these seeds in that hole. Now take a fish and put it with the seeds.
Ew, slimy. That fish is so slimy.
Yeah, slimy.
Ooh, slimy.
Here, Great Brave, you can stick the fish in.
Maybe humility should do it.
Maybe when you are older. Sometimes it can be dangerous. Last week, we ran into a party of Indian warriors. If I had not spoken to them in their native tongue, they would have attacked.
Mr. Squanto, are you ever lonely?
Yes, many times. All of my family died of smallpox 2 years ago. I've told you this story, haven't I?
Yes, you told us. I miss my Aunt Anne and Uncle Edward who died last week in the general sickness.
Me too, I really miss them.
My dad died too. It's really hard. Sometimes I feel like quitting.
I felt like that too, but God helped me. He made me go to England to learn English so that I could help you. Now, you are my people, and I'm not so lonely.
My mom says if it weren't for you, we wouldn't have survived this winter.
God surely did have a plan for me, didn't he?
Squanto and the Pilgrims planted that spring, prospered and grew tall. After the harvest, the Pilgrims invited their Indian friends to join them for a celebration of Thanksgiving to God. Chief Massasoit came to the feast with 90 hungry braves. Fortunately, the Indians shot 5 deer to help feed the large company. Governor Bradford greets the guests.
When we've all gathered, we will pray and then begin.
Turkeys, venison, and cornbread.
And clams and eels. Ew, eels. And goose and berries. I like goose.
Quiet now, children.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you for our friend, Mr. Squanto.
Amen. Amen.